Hello everyone. So today I'm going to show you how to connect Visual Studio Code to MySQL. And you have to download Visual Studio Code to go through this and understand this tutorial. It is better to download Visual Studio Code. And as I go through this tutorial, you also do the same thing using your Visual Studio Code. Okay. And you also need to download MySQL. The MySQL Community Edition is free. I have created a tutorial on this. You can go to the description and you can find the links to download and install these tools. So let's start this. So I have the latest Visual Studio Code, which is 2022 version, version 1.7. So here you can see that there is a left navigation pane here, and the last one is extensions. So you have to install some extensions to implement this connectivity between Visual Studio Code and MySQL. So this first extension which we will need here is called as SQLtools. Now select this SQLtool and install. Now it has been installed. So once it is installed, you can see a icon like this on the left side. Click on this and then click on add new connection. Okay, so we should get an error here. Yes, so you can see that couldn't find any installed drivers, so that is expected error. So in order to get rid of this, you need to install one more thing, that is a driver. So click on this link here, search Visual Studio Code Marketplace. So when you click, it automatically does a search through this tag, and then the first item here, okay, SQLtools, MySQL. So you have to install this, right? So this is the author, and then you have to install this. So click on install, and then the driver will get installed. So once the driver gets installed, you can go back to the SQLtools and click on add new connection. Now you can see the MySQL icon here. So click on MySQL icon, and then you will be asked to enter these details. This is required for Visual Studio to get connected to MySQL. So we will give some name here, connection name. So tutor demo is my connection name. And then localhost is where MySQL is installed. And database, I will let's say give this database. This database doesn't exist yet, but I will show you how to create it, and then we will connect. Username, for the time being, I will use the default username. Here, use password, you just select the last one so that it will ask you to enter a password. When you install MySQL, so it will ask you to create a user ID and give a password there. Okay, so you can check my video in the description. There I have shown you how to do that, how to install and what user, how to create that user. So here the root is the username, and then I will give my password. Okay. So and we can then leave rest of the connection, rest of the things as it is, and then save connection. Okay, now it is saved. So you can see a connection here coming up. Okay, so what we can do is click on this, and then you see there is another error. Okay, which is client does not support authentication protocol requested by server. So this is because the Visual Studio Code and MySQL, there is a compatibility issue. MySQL is the latest version which I have installed here. So the 8.x version, so that uses a different protocol which is not supported by a lot of clients. So that is why you see this error here. So in order to resolve this error, we have to create a user which supports this protocol. Okay, so and using that user and the so you can see that I have used root user here, right? The username is root. I'll create another user with a different name, and then use that username here. So that will allow Visual Studio to connect using the old protocol. with MySQL. Okay. So in order to do that, you have to open the command prompt of MySQL. So for example, I am here searching MySQL and this is the command line client. So open this. So I'll enter my password here. You enter whatever password you have provided. Now I am in the MySQL prompt. So now I have typed this command here. So create user so-and-so, tutor user, okay, and give a password. So I have given password ABCDEF. So you can give whatever password you want, and then you can see that the user has been created. So this is query, okay, 0 rows affected, okay, so the user has been created successfully. So the next step is to grant all the permissions to this user. So type this command and then hit enter. Now you can see this query also got executed. So and then after that you have to validate all the permissions. So now this will validate all the permissions. Now this is done. So the user has been successfully created. So now since the user has been created, what we will do is we'll go back and edit this connection. The new user that I have created, I have entered those details here. In the database, you have to give a database which already exists. So there is a default database which exists in MySQL. It is called as world. So I am giving that database name here for this to work. So let's test the connectivity and you can see successfully connected. So you have to give a database which already exists, not a database which is not existing. It didn't allow me to create a connection if a database is not existing. So that is why I am now removing the earlier database which I provided. Rather, I am now providing a database name which is already there in MySQL. If you want to create a database, what you can do, you can also use the MySQL Workbench, which you can, if I search here MySQL, you can see this Workbench is there. So I'll just open it and show how to create a database. So here, this is my Workbench, which is basically GUI, which allows you to interact directly with MySQL. Okay, so click on this local instance. It is now, see, this is the root user, and now I have to enter my password here. So you can see here the default databases are here. Okay, if you want to create a new database, you can click on this link here and it will ask you to give a name. So for example, if I say test schema, so this is my new database name. So and then click on apply, then it will ask you this one. So just don't do anything, just apply and finish. So this will create a new database here. Okay, similarly, you can right click and create table, and you can do all these things using the GUI. Okay, but so why I'm showing it to you, so in case you want to create a database using the GUI, you can also do it, but you can also do it through the Visual Studio code editor. Okay, now here instead of world, I can give this test schema also and it will work. Okay, so for example, if I give test schema here and say test connection, and you can see that it is successfully connected again to test schema. So you have to give a database which is existing. So that is the point. And once you have done it, you can save the connection. Okay, and then we can go back here and refresh it. We should see all these things available here, right? So test schema, Sagila, and world. So these are the databases which is available. It is not showing the system database, the sys database, which you can see here. So here you can see a sys, which is a system database that is not needed. Only the user databases are needed, which we are interested in, right? So these are the databases. We can also create database from here. So for that, just write create database, and in my case I will create a database called as world movie. So basically it's a movie database. So and then semicolon, and here you can see this run on active connection, and this should create the database for us. Okay, so now the database has been created. If you click on this refresh, it should appear here. So you can see World Movie Database is appearing. Okay, now this doesn't contain any tables, right? So the next step is to create the tables. So let's create the tables. So now this is a small table which contains a ID column, which is auto incremental column, and then name, release year, country. Okay, so this is the movie name, this is the release year, and then the country in which the movie was produced. So that is the table. So let's then run it again and let's refresh this. So now you can see the table has been created. But if we show table records, it should be blank because nothing is there in that. You can see that there is no data in the this thing, but the table has been created. You can see the fields here, ID, name, release year, country. Okay, but there is no record, there is no data. Let's enter, insert some data now. So now this is the seed data which I want to insert in this table. So insert into, this is the table name, the data. So you have to use this database name and the table name, and then the field names here, and then some you know, whatever data you want to insert, you can insert that, and then use this comma. Okay, and then in the end a semicolon. So let's run it again. So this should get inserted now, and now go to show table records. So the table should come up now. Yes, so now you can see the data has come up now. So with three records in it, we can again actually run it. You can just see two. I just added number two, okay, to the data, kept rest of the things as it is. So run it and then right click, show table records, and it should show the updated table with six records. So yeah, so six records are there because I did it two times. So that's how you connect Visual Studio Code to MySQL and create database. And this is how you can also insert, you can create tables and insert records into the tables. So all these things can be done through Visual Studio, which was the intention of this tutorial, and I have shown you how to do it. Hope it will help you. Please subscribe to my channel and post your comments. Thanks for watching.